In our last journey into the population genetics of the British Isles, we uncovered a complex tapestry of ancestry woven by millennia of migration. But as many of you rightly pointed out, that story was incomplete. A crucial chapter was missing, that of Ireland. So today, we address that missing chapter. We are going to use science to explore the deep genetic history of Ireland and its relationship to the rest of the British Isles. For clarity, in this video essay, we'll use the following terminology. Irish will refer to individuals with deep ancestral roots to the island of Ireland, both Republic and Northern Ireland. British, meanwhile, will refer to those with similar roots to Great Britain. These genetic labels are for scientific exploration and explanation. Political, geographical, and national labels will need to be brushed aside for the length of this video for clarity.
The first question is, what is the population structure in Ireland?
To understand the genetic landscape of Ireland today, we turn to a landmark 2017 study known as the Irish DNA Atlas. Researchers analysed the DNA of nearly 550 Irish individuals, comparing them to over 1,500 individuals from across the rest of the British Isles. Using modern techniques to examine hundreds of thousands of unique genetic markers, they were able to create a genetic map of Ireland with unprecedented detail. The results were stunning. Far from being a single, homogeneous group, the analysis revealed 10 distinct genetic clusters on the island today. The first and most striking finding was a clear split within the Irish groups. 7 of them were identified as Gaelic Irish groups, which largely dominated the central and southern regions of Ireland, whereas 3 were identified as British Irish, and they were predominantly found in the northern section of Ireland. Even more fascinating, these 7 Gaelic clusters align almost perfectly with ancient provincial and political boundaries in pre-Norman Ireland. We see distinct genetic signatures for Ulster, Leinster, Munster, and Connacht. Ghosts of several ancient Irish kingdoms are still visible today in the DNA of the people who lived there. This tells us for centuries, these regions remained remarkably isolated from one another. And if anyone has any historical clues on this, please share them in the comments below. But the data had another surprise. When placed in the broader context of the British Isles, these 7 Gaelic clusters grouped much more closely with Orkney Islanders, a population we previously identified as the most genetically distinct in the entire region, and was heavily shaped by a powerful Norse Scandinavian heritage. This is not to say that the Gaelic Irish are simply Vikings. The genetic distance is very clear. Rather, it reveals a profound and shared history. The Viking Age in Ireland, which began around 1200 years ago, was not just an era of coastal raids. It was a period of settlement, integration, and intermarriage that left a permanent genetic layer across the entire Gaelic population. A layer that distinguishes them from the modern English, who were shaped by different historical forces. But the most intriguing puzzle was found in Northern Ireland. The analysis revealed that the Gaelic Ulster cluster was, in one sense, the most Irish of them all. On one genetic axis, it was the population most distant from the core English genetic identity. Yet on another, it was the closest to the North Welsh, the population we established as the clearest modern link to pre-Roman and pre-Anglo-Saxon people of Britain. This is not a contradiction, it is a confirmation. It suggests that in this corner of Gaelic Ireland, preserved the deepest layer of ancient Celtic ancestry, a genetic signal that was later diluted in other regions, making it a unique window into the island's most ancient past.
Staying on the topic of ancient Celtic heritage, how much gene flow was going on between these ancient Celtic groups that lived in Ireland and Wales?
To understand how these groups interacted, the researchers created a map of effective migration. Think of it as a map of history's genetic highways and barriers. Dark brown colors show areas where the gene flow in the region is estimated to be 100 times lower than average, and cool blue colors show areas where gene flow in the region is estimated to be 100 times greater than the average. The results show a portrait of history and genealogy. The Irish Sea appears to be a major barrier that drastically limited gene flow between Ireland and Wales and the rest of England for millennia. We also see genetic barriers within Ireland itself, particularly between ancient provinces of Leinster and Munster, no doubt a product of several mountain ranges which split these two provinces. But there are also genetic highways. Bright blue-coloured corridors run directly between southwest Scotland and Northern Ireland. This is the genetic signature of the plantations of Ulster in the 17th century, a well-documented historical event where large numbers of Scottish and English settlers moved into the region. This migration seemed to be so significant that it created three distinct British-Irish clusters that we see in modern Ireland today, linking the genetics of Northern Ireland and Scotland inextricably. This leaves us with one final profound question. With all of these layers of history, who is genetically closer to the ancient foundational people of these isles? The researchers tackled this by comparing the modern groups of Britain to the DNA of two ancient Irish genomes, a 5,200-year-old Neolithic farmer known as Balanati, and a 4,000-year-old Bronze Age man known as Rathlin I. The plots shown on the screen measured the length of unbroken DNA. The more genetically similar two individuals are, for example, a parent-child relationship, the longer the section of DNA will be intact, whilst distant cousins, in contrast, would have many more mutations and therefore shorter segments of DNA would be intact. The results were conclusive. Looking at contrast to Neolithic Balanhati, we see a large drop in similarity to the Orkney Islanders, which is no surprise, but we see no modern population or geographic grouping being significantly closer to Neolithic Balanhati. We could note the relative dissimilarity between Neolithic Balanhati to Northern Wales, which is one aspect which I did not expect. Also looking at Bronze Age Rathlin I, we see a similar trend, and again a slight dip when it comes to comparisons with Northern Wales and also Northern England. It's quite surprising that the Celtic link from Northern Wales is very dissimilar to both Bronze Age and Neolithic ancient genomes. Although this does align with the effective migration results, where a genomic barrier is drawn between Irish and Welsh gene flow, perhaps indicating that the Celtic populations dotted around the British Isles were not in close contact for millennia. Overall, no single modern population, not Irish, not Scottish, not Welsh, not English, showed a significantly stronger link to these ancient ancestors when contrasted against any other. That deep Neolithic and Bronze Age heritage is a foundational layer shared by almost all of the descendants on these islands. What this tells us is powerful. The distinct genetic clusters we see today, the differences between the Gaelic, Irish, Welsh, Scottish, and English are not the result of ancient deep divisions. they are a product of more recent history. The events of the last 1500 years, from the Anglo-Saxon migrations to Britain to the Viking Age in Ireland and the Norman conquest of Britain, were profoundly powerful forces that sculpted the modern genetic landscape we see today. There were several limitations to this video essay, such as glossing over the ancient Neolithic migrations and ancestral European links the British Isles have. I would be interested in making a follow-up video to address these points. Please give this video a like and subscribe to the Scientific Journal Club for more stories about evolutionary biology and anthropology. See you next time for more science.